स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ग्रेड 9 मैथमेटिक्स पॉलीनोमियल्स पार्ट 7। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रिमाइंडर थ्योरम एंड फैक्टर थ्योरम। अलॉन्ग विद दैट वी विल डिस्कस देयर एप्लीकेशंस। रिमाइंडर थ्योरम, लेट पी एक्स बी एनी पॉलीनोमियल ऑफ डिग्री ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 1 एंड ए बी एनी रियल कॉन्स्टेंट इफ पॉलीनोमियल पी एक्स इज डिवाइडेड बाय द लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. Now, what is the meaning of this theorem? This theorem means that if you are having any polynomial of degree greater than equal to 1, that means its degree has to be greater than or equal to 1, it cannot be 0. If the degree of any polynomial is 0, it means it is a constant polynomial. So that we don't require that polynomial. Which we require is a proper polynomial which will be containing some variable, and it can contain some variable if and only if its degree is greater than 1, that means 2, 3, 4 like that, or equal to 1, that means it can be x, it may be 2x, it may be x plus 5. The polynomials can be of all these forms: x, 2x, x plus 5, 2x minus 7, or something like that, right? So therefore, this part is very important, that the degree of the polynomial has to be greater than or equal to 1. And a be any real constant. And a has to be, that means the value of x that you will assign it has to be some number. Maybe it is a irrational number, maybe it is rational, it has to be a real number, right? It can be rational, it can be irrational, it can be natural, it can be whole number, any kind of number. Now, if polynomial px is divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, that means the two polynomials are being divided, then the remainder is given by substituting x is equal to a in the given polynomial, right? Whatever polynomial is given, see by which you are dividing, and then put it equal to 0. X minus a can be put to 0, so that means x is equal to a. Put that value of a in the given polynomial. So whatever answer will come, that is going to be the remainder. Let us see it through some examples. Find the remainder when px is divided by qx without actually dividing. So this remainder theorem is very useful. That is, without performing any long division method, we are able to guess what is going to be the remainder. Now, if the polynomial is x square minus 3x plus 2 and qx is x minus 1, right? I have to find the remainder when this px is divided by qx. For this, what do we do? We will put x minus 1 to be equal to 0, which will give me x is equal to 1. Now put this value of x in the given polynomial px. So what do I get? Remainder will be p of 1, that is 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2, which is equal to 1 minus 3 plus 2, that is 3 minus 3, which is equal to 0. Now, px is equal to x cube plus 1 and qx is equal to x plus 1. Now, what will be the remainder? Then what will I do? Put x plus 1 is equal to 0. This implies x is equal to minus 1. Remainder will be p of minus 1, that is equal to minus 1 whole cube plus 1, which is equal to minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. So in both these questions, we have noticed that the remainder comes out to be 0. Let's take one more example. Px is equal to 3x raised to the power 4 minus 4x cube minus 3x minus 1, where gx is equal to x minus 1. Now we are going to divide px by this gx. Then what will be the remainder? Let's see. Remainder will be p of 1, that is equal to 3 times 1 raised to the power 4 minus 4 into 1 cube minus 3 into 1 plus minus 1, which is equal to 3 minus 4 minus 3 minus 1, that's equal to minus 5. So the remainder in this case is going to be minus 5. Let us verify whether this remainder theorem is true or not. For that, Let us divide it actually and see. 3x raised to the power 4 minus 4x cubed minus 3x minus 1 is divided by x minus 1. So I can take 3x cubed when multiplied with x will give me 3x raised to the power 4. When it is multiplied by minus 1, it gives me minus 3x cubed. Change the signs. You get this is cancelled and you get here minus x cubed minus 3x minus 1. Now, I want minus x cubed. So, I will multiply it by minus x square, which gives me minus x cubed plus x square, because minus and minus will become plus. Now change the signs, this becomes plus and this becomes minus. So these x cubes, they get cancelled and I have here, now see here there is x square but here it is minus 3x. So I cannot add or subtract them. So I will just write them, write in standard form, minus x square minus 3x minus 1. Now I want minus x square on multiplying. Right, so here I take minus x will be suitable so that I get minus x square. So multiply here, minus x square plus x. Again change the signs, x square terms cancel and I'm left with minus 4x minus 1. That now let us take minus 4, that will be suitable. So minus 4 into x gives me minus 4x plus 4. Again change the signs, minus 4 and plus 4, this will get cancelled and here I am left with minus 5. Alright, so minus 5 is the remainder, hence we have verified that by remainder theorem also I was getting the remainder minus 5 and by actual division also the remainder is this much. You see how convenient it is to use the remainder theorem. Now let us see one more thing. Let's see, if the remainder comes out to be 0 here, then I can say the divisor is a factor of given polynomial. But if it is not 0, then I say that x minus 1 is not the factor of the given polynomial. Keeping this in mind, there comes factor theorem. Now, if Px is a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1 and for any real constant a, x minus a is the factor of the polynomial Px if and only if P of a is 0. What do you mean by if and only if? It means that the converse is also true. That means in simple words, I can say if P of A is equal to 0, this implies X minus A is the factor of Px. And if X minus A is the factor of Px, then P of A is equal to 0. Check whether X plus 3 is the factor of X square plus 3X plus 6. For this, let us first find out the remainder. That means whenever I have to make use of the factor theorem, we have to make use of the remainder theorem also. So for finding the remainder, first put x plus 3 is equal to 0. This implies x is equal to minus 3. Now, P of minus 3 is equal to minus 3 square plus 3 times minus 3 plus 6. That is equal to 9 minus 9 plus 6. Plus 9 and minus 9, they get cancelled. This is equal to 6 greater than 0. Now that means that x plus 3 is not the factor of x square plus 3x plus 6. Question number 2. Is P minus 1 the factor of P raised to the power 10 minus 1 and P raised to the power 11 minus 1. For this now, what I have done, I have taken first case, that is P is equal to 1. When you will put it equal to 0, you will get P is equal to 1. Put P is equal to 1 in P raised to the power 10 minus 1. This implies that 1 raised to the power 10 minus 1 will be equal to 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. That means the remainder is 0. If remainder is 0, I will say P p-1 is the factor of p⁻¹. Now put p=1 in p⁻¹-1. Again, what do I get? 1⁻¹⁻¹ is equal to 1-1, which is equal to 0. Again, the remainder is 0. So that means p-1 is the factor of p⁻¹⁻¹. Let's see one more example. Is x+2 the factor of x³ + 3x² + 3x + 1? Put x+2 is equal to 0, you get x is equal to -2. Now put x is equal to -2 in the given expression. So I get -2³ + 3 × -2² + 3 × 2 + 1. That is equal to -8 + 12 + 6 + 1, which is equal to -8 + 19 = 11, which is not equal to 0. So here I will say that x+2 is not the factor of the given polynomial. Question number 4. Find the value of k if x-1 is the factor of x² + x + k. Solution: if x-1 is the factor of this x² + x + k, then by factor theorem the remainder should have been 0. That means f(1) will be equal to 0, which implies 1² + 1 + k will be equal to 0. Now just solve it, you get k is equal to -2. So this was the application of factor theorem. Let's take one more question for having more practice. Find the value of k so that x-2 is the factor of 3x³ + 4x² - 5x - 5k. If x-2 is the factor of given expression, then the remainder should be 0. That means p(2) will be equal to 0, which implies 3 × 2⁻³ + 4 × 2⁻²⁺ - 5 × 2 - 5k is equal to 0, which implies 24 + 16 - 10 - 5k is equal to 0, implies 30 - 5k is equal to 0, which implies 30 = 5k, implies k is equal to k. For further clarification, let's have one more question. Show that x+1 × x+2 is a factor of the polynomial x³ + 8x² + 17x + 10. Here we will put x = -1 and x = -2 separately and check whether p⁻¹ is 0 and p⁻²² is 0. Because if both of them are separately factors, then only the product can be the factor. Now p⁻¹ will be equal to -1 × 8 × -1² + 17 × -1 + 10. That is equal to -1 + 8 - 17 + 10, which is equal to 7 - 17 + 10 is equal to 0. This implies that x-1 is the factor because remainder is 0. Now let's find out p⁻². p⁻²is equal to -2³ + 8 × -2² + 17 × -2 + 10, which is equal to -8 + 32 - 34 + 10. That is equal to 42 - 42 is equal to 0. Again, the remainder is 0. Hence, I can say that x+2 is also the factor of px. Thus, x + 1 × x + 2 is also the factor of px. I repeat, if they are separately factors, then product is also the factor. Thank you.